Bersabal versus Honorable Judge Serafin Salvador, GR number L-39359910, July 21, 1978. On March 23, 1972, Petitioner Purina Bersabal seeks to annul the orders of Respondent Judge of August 4, 1971, October 30, 1971, and March 15, 1972, and to compel said Respondent Judge to decide Petitioner's perfected appeal on the basis of the evidence and records of the case submitted by the City Court of Caloocan City plus the memorandum already submitted by the Petitioner and Respondents. Since only questions of law are raised therein, the Court of Appeals on October 30, 1972 issued a resolution certifying said case to this court pursuant to Section 17, Paragraph 4 of the Judiciary Act of 1948 as amended. As found by the Court of Appeals, the facts of this case are as follows. It appears that private respondents Tan Dat and Ong Ping T filed an injunction docketed as civil case number 69-26 in the City Court of Caloocan City against the petitioner. A decision was rendered by said court on November 25, 1970, which decision was appealed by the petitioner to the respondent court and docketed therein as civil case number C-2036. During the pendency of the appeal, the respondent court issued on March 23, 1971, an order which reads, pursuant to the provisions of Republic Act number 6031, the Clerk of Court of Caloocan City is hereby directed to transmit to this court within 15 days from receipt hereof the transcripts of stenographic notes taken down during the hearing of this case before the City Court of Caloocan City, and likewise counsels for both parties are given 30 days from the receipt of this order within which to file their respective memoranda, and thereafter this case shall be deemed submitted for decision by this court, which order was apparently received by petitioner on April 17, 1971. The transcript of stenographic notes not having yet been forwarded to the respondent court, petitioner filed on May 5, 1971, a motion ex parte to submit memorandum within 30 days from receipt of notice of submission of the transcript of stenographic notes taken during the hearing of the case before the City Court of Caloocan City, which was granted by Respondent Court on May 7, 1971. However, before the petitioner could receive any such notice from the Respondent Court, the Respondent Judge issued an order on August 4, 1971, which says, for failure of the defendant appellant to prosecute her appeal, the same is hereby ordered dismissed with costs against her. Petitioner filed a motion for reconsideration of the order on September 28, 1971, citing as a ground the granting of his ex parte motion to submit memorandum within 30 days from notice of the submission of the stenographic notes taken before the City Court. Private respondents filed their opposition to the motion on September 30, 1971. In the meantime, on October 2, 1971, petitioner filed her memorandum dated October 18, 1971. On October 30, 1971, the respondent court denied the motion for reconsideration. Then on January 25, 1972, petitioner filed a motion for leave to file a second motion for reconsideration, which was likewise denied by the respondent court on March 15, 1972, hence this petition. The sole inquiry in the case at bar can be stated thus, whether in the light of the provisions of the second paragraph of Section 45 of RA 296 as amended by RA 6031, the mere failure of an appellant to submit on time the memorandum mentioned in the same paragraph would empower the court of first instance to dismiss the appeal on the ground of failure to prosecute, or whether it is mandatory upon said court to proceed to decide the appeal case on the basis of the evidence and records transmitted to it, the failure of the appellant to submit a memorandum on time notwithstanding. The second paragraph of Section 45 of RA 296, otherwise known as the Philippine Judiciary Act of 1948, as amended by RA 6031, provides in part as follows. Courts of first instance shall decide such appeal cases on the basis of the evidence and records transmitted from the city or municipal courts, provided that the parties may submit memoranda or brief with oral argument if so requested. The foregoing provision is clear and leaves no room for doubt. It cannot be interpreted otherwise than that The submission of memoranda is optional on the part of the parties. Being optional on the part of the parties, the letter may so choose to waive submission of the memoranda. It is logical concomitant of the choice given to the parties. The court cannot dismiss the appeal of the party waiving the submission of said memorandum. If the appellant so chooses not to submit the memorandum, the court of first instance is left with no alternative but to decide the case on the basis of the evidence and records transmitted from the city or municipal courts. In other words, the court is not empowered by law to dismiss the appeal on the mere failure of an appellant to submit his memorandum, but rather it is the court's mandatory duty to decide the case on the basis of the available evidence and records transmitted to it. As a general rule, the word may, when used in a statute, is permissive only and operates to confer discretion, while the word shall is imperative, operating to impose a duty which may be enforced. The implication that the court is left with no choice but to decide the appealed case either on the basis of the evidence and records transmitted to it, or on the basis of the latter, plus memoranda and or brief with oral argument duly submitted and or made on request. Moreover, memoranda, briefs, and oral arguments are not essential requirements. They may be submitted and or made only if so requested. Finally, a contrary interpretation would be unjust and dangerous as it may defeat the litigant's right to appeal granted to him by law. In the case of Republic versus Rodriguez, this court underscored the need of proceeding with caution so that a party may not be deprived of its right to appeal except for weighty reasons. Courts should heed the rule of Municipality of Tiwi Albay versus Cirojales. Thus, the appellate court's summary dismissal of the appeal even before receipt of the records of the appeal case as ordered by it in a prior mandamus case must be set aside as having been issued precipitously and without an opportunity to consider and appreciate unavoidable circumstances of record not attributable to petitioners that caused the delay in the elevation of the records of the case on appeal. In the instant case, no notice was received by petitioner about the submission of the transcript of the stenographic notes so that his 30-day period to submit his memorandum would commence to run. Only after the expiration of such period can the respondent judge act on the case by deciding on its merits, not by dismissing the appeal of the petitioner. Wherefore, the challenged orders of respondent judge dated August 4, 1971, October 30, 1971, and March 15, 1971 are hereby set aside as null and void, and the respondent court is hereby directed to decide civil case number C2036 on the merits. No costs yung decision dito, no? So, ano na naman ito? Another procedural, no? So, isummarize natin ulit. Ano yung issue, no? So, dismissal or failure to submit memorandum, whether the court of first instance can dismiss an appeal solely for the appellant's failure to submit a memorandum on time. Second is mandatory decision based on evidence, whether it is mandatory for the court of first instance to decide the appealed case on the basis of evidence and records transmitted to it despite the appellant's failure to submit the memorandum. So, anong ruling? Dismissal authority, the Supreme Court ruled that the court in first instance is not empowered by law to dismiss an appeal solely for the appellant's failure to submit a memorandum. Supreme Court directed the respondent court to decide the case on the merits based on the evidence and records submitted from the city court of Caloocan City. So, without the consideration of the memorandums, etc., yung importante is yung mga na-submit, no, na mga documents. So, the legal basis, the decision was based on the second paragraph of Section 45, Republic Act Number 296, as amended by RA 6031. No? The law states that submitting memoranda is optional for the parties. The term may is permissive, allowing parties to choose whether to submit a memorandum, while shall is imperative, imposing a mandatory duty. No? The CFI must decide the case based on the available evidence and records even if the appellants fail to submit the memorandum. So, may sinubmit man o wala kung ano yung available na mga records and evidence, yun na yung gagamitin ng court to decide. Memoranda, briefs, and oral arguments are not essential but may be submitted if requested. No, emphasize the importance of not depriving a litigant of the right to appeal except for significant reasons. The respondent judge acted prematurely by dismissing the appeal before the expiration of the period granted for submitting the memorandum. No, so 30 days yon. The court set aside the challenge orders as null and void and directed the respondent court to decide on the case on its merits. So that is the case of Bersabal versus Honorable Judge Serafin Salvador, GR number L-35910, July 21, 1978. No, it's about the use of may or shall in a statute.